Good evening. We're opening up CBA board meeting. Our first agenda item is a continuance, is opening of an agenda of Park Central. Karen, would you read the request, please?
To Chairman Southborough Board of Appeals from William DePetri in reference to Park Central. Applicant is William DePetri, 259 Turnpike Road, Suite 100, Southborough. I, the above applicant or duly authorized representative of such applicant, hereby request and agree, one, to the continuance of the above referenced hearing related to the above referenced matter and extension of the board's time to reach a decision on such matter. The hearing shall be continued to September 23rd, 2015.
Okay, thank you. Can we get a motion? There is no other agenda on that night, so we'll set it for 7:30. So we need a motion to continue.
What's the date of the next meeting?
The 23rd of September. There's a four, it's a 5-week month, but we'll do it on the fourth week.
All right, I'll make a motion to extend the public hearing to the 23rd at 7:30.
A second? Okay, any discussion? All in favor? Tom?
Thank you.
And we have the other one he filled out, right? Have you gentlemen read the minutes for what minutes were they, Karen? The 29th. Are there any issues with those minutes? Everybody reviewed those minutes?
Yep.
Tom? Yes.
Yep. Okay. Looks good.
Okay. I want to make a motion to approve the minutes of July 29th.
So moved.
Okay. All in favor? Any discussion on them? All in favor? Aye. Okay. I made a motion. Okay. Request we do a 10-minute recess.
Sounds good.
Okay. Okay. Second?
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Okay, we ready? We're going into a discussion on the letter that was requested from Mr. DePietri for Stony Brook Village. The board has received the letter on that, correct? Has everybody read it?
Yep.
On Stony Brook? Okay, the other letter was a letter that was sent to Mass Housing on that, okay? The issue is of substantial, or is substantial, process on this. The drawings that we've been given, excuse me, Mr. DePietri and Mr. Cassaro, would you sit up here, please?
Do you want me to give an overview, or?
No, this is not a public discussion, and the reason you're here is in case we have questions to ask you. The board has the question. We have your letter of representation that you sent us, and we have these drawings. Are there other drawings than these that were labeled?
Yeah, we have labeled the plan, which we are hoping that you conclude is an insubstantial change, as a 40B.
And it's the same one as you sent us already?
It's the same one, but it's.
It has the words 40B on it.
Can we have that?
Can I just have one back?
We just say 40B. Yep. Now, we have, these here are the same ones everybody already has.
Same plan, that's good. The only change is that one word.
Those three words.
You're gonna get all these.
Okay.
Anyway, if you need one for us.
Because it's got the title, 40B.
Yeah, and then you're gonna need one for the town clerk. These are the same ones, if you guys want them, it just has the one change on it right there. Okay? Take those, pass them out to everybody. Now, have you reviewed the plans? On the thing? Well, we have one other letter, which is not, what do you call it, but I'm just wondering. We received a letter yesterday from Mr. Baccarat. Have the board members read the letter and reviewed that? Okay, everybody's read it and reviewed it?
Yes.
Okay. So, the first thing on this is to take, and I've talked to Ed Monchon, and he's our consultant from the state on the 40B projects. The first thing was, he explained the issue on the consultants of doing, we have to do this in 20 days. Today is the 16th day of it, and that is just a discussion, not a public hearing or anything. And it's the board to make a decision whether it's substantial or insubstantial of the review of the plans. And the other issue is to grant a 40B 55 and over project, which are the two major substantial issues that are here. One issue that's on the drawing, and I don't know, I mean, I know Tom and David were the originals and myself when we approved this in the beginning. One of the issues is there's a piece of land added under the regulations of the 40B that does not matter. If it was taken away, then it'd be a different deal completely.
Right.
But where it was added, it doesn't matter at all. I've gone over the drawings pretty precisely, and there's some small intermediate changes here and there from the drawing we did. This drawing was approved by the planning board back in December 13 for the 55 and over project, which is basically the same drawing as we had, done by the same engineers that we had do our drawing when we approved the 40B project. So the drawing had been approved by the planning board and everything, and what we've been asked to do is take that under the 40B project, which Mr. Monchon said there is no issues in doing that, and because there is no major changes in the design of the drawing or anything at all. The other issue is that in the letter that was sent to Mass Housing, if they had any questions, is the fact of doing the, giving them the decision of doing a 55 and over project, which would mean that all units, including affordable units, would only be allowed to be sold to 55 and over people in the town of Southborough. Our original decision stays in place, And in the original decision, which I reviewed it a little bit, it's been so long since we did it, but in the original decision, it was mandated that Town of Southborough residents have first refusal on these units the way they were, which that would stay in condition under the new process if we approve it the way it is. And in talking to some seniors in the town, which I did that the last couple of days, there are a lot of them that are very in favor of something like this because they're looking for housing. There's been several meetings with the town planner and Shopsy on 55 and over projects of, you know, housing for the seniors and what they're looking for. So in the general fund, this would be a major issue for the seniors in the town of Southborough, and it'd be one of the only projects in town that are done this way under the seniors to guarantee, you know, 55 and over. And there's some people will be able to get the low income housing ones, and then the other ones would be able to be sold to anybody that would want to buy them, but they would be 55 and over, and the residents of the town of Southborough would get first priority. There is a non-agreement is changed that it's only for the first sale. It is not for the second sale, like the old 55 and over project was, that the units would go and they would be sold. But under the decision, it's not that way anyways under the 40B. So anybody buys it, when they go to sell it, they can sell it to whoever they would like to. So there's no issue under that at all on this in our decision, because our original decision all stays the same. All we're doing is either approving, saying yes to the request or no to the request, cut and dry, very simple. And the drawing would then get filed, and then we sign it and we file it with the town clerk's office, and that's it. So. Any discussion or any questions of the board, any of the board members have, you can ask Mr. Catanzaro or you can ask me. I've done a lot of research on the engineering part of it, so unless there's any questions that anybody has.
I got a couple questions.
Okay.
So I'm trying, what I didn't have in the materials, I don't think, I know that this is the, these are the site plans for the slightly modified senior housing development that was slightly different from the original 40B layout, and I don't think we have in here, we probably have my files, is the original 40B.
The original 40B plan is the 2009 plan that was part of right the application that we submitted. We also submitted the 2013 senior housing plan, okay, which, and Mr. Bartolini had indicated, was approved by the planning board in connection with that senior housing project. The planning board actually approved a subdivision plan, okay,
right.
And a low and a special permit for a low impact development, and it also had a site plan approval. So there were three planning board approvals in connection with that project. This board approved the 2013 plan also as part of the special permit.
Yeah, so I understand we originally, and I actually was on the board at the time, we approved the original 40B project.
Correct.
That had one layout.
Right.
Yes.
A couple years later, I came on the board and we approved the senior housing project, which had a slightly different layout.
Correct.
And so I'm just, so what you're doing now is looking to do the 40B project in the layout of the special senior housing.
The exact layout.
Yeah. And it's, like you said, it's something we've already approved.
And Angela, can you just point to me which one's the original 40B? I guess I can't tell the difference.
Right here.
The
plans. I'm going to do it for you.
It's the original.
Yeah, I have, you know what?
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, I also have 10 copies of
this one's
one.
Updated through 2013, so that's not the one.
You would, yeah, but go ahead.
The 2009 plan is the...
That's the original 40B approval?
That's the one that you approved.
That's
correct.
This one here.
Here's some...
Okay, that's so original. That's different.
This,
okay.
Yeah, no, it's basically all the same.
Okay, gotcha.
And that was submitted in an 8.5 by 11, but we brought the larger ones.
Okay.
Yeah. And then there's an overlay plan that was also
what's
submitted.
What's that, Andrew?
That tried, it's attached, but it's really more confusing than it's than it's worth. But
I
there,
see.
There is an open, and we have a large one.
That was
that
in
too.
Our materials.
Yeah. Okay. Well, there is a small one, but piece by piece, Mr. DiPietri is giving me everything. And here's a larger version of the overlay plan.
Gotcha. So, sorry. So one thing that the Mr. Brockhart's letter noted in objection was that under the new plan, there's, you know, there's two units that we did approve under the senior housing. But with respect to the original 40B project, there's two units that are now closer to the Lutel property and the Perone property. So I guess one question there is whether that's a substantial or insubstantial change.
Well, I mean, in our view, it is not a substantial change. The regs also point out some guidelines, although they're not very specific. And some of the relocation of buildings is not generally considered a substantial change. What's significant about these regulations is that it clearly leaves to this board's discretion what is substantial and insubstantial. But I even think that Mr. Bachrach, and I only read his letter this evening because I was tied up all day, I think he's attached those regs to his letter. And substantial changes, the regs say that the following matters generally will not be substantial changes: and a reduction in the number of units, a decrease of less than 10% of the floor areas, a change in the number of bedrooms within individual units, okay, a change in the color or style materials used. So the regs say those are not substantial changes. And of course, those are sort of like the changes that we did. The regs suggest that if we're increasing the height of the buildings by more than 10%, or if we're increasing more than 10% of the number of units, or a reduction of the size of the units, or a change of the building type, or, okay, a change of from for sale to rental, then those would be substantial changes. But those are the only examples that they give us.
What do you make, and they're not being done.
What do you make of their point of the change from the form of housing tenure from non-age restricted to age restricted?
Our opinion is that's not what the reg was addressing itself to, that the regulation was addressing itself to the kinds of projects that are contemplated under 40B, namely for sale or for rental. But again, I could find no cases that suggested otherwise, and I understand that the town also consulted with Mr. Marchand, who also concurred that just imposing an age restriction is, if this board agrees, it's not a substantial change.
I mean, it's also less of an impact. The other one had kids, more traffic. This has no kids, less traffic.
Yeah, I mean, it's, the question really isn't impact. It's the magnitude of the variation from the original 40B to the current plan.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I have for that.
Andrew?
I think Tom asked the main question that I had, which was about whether the change in the going from not age restricted to age restricted is whether that's a substantial change. And I understand your position and what the position Mr. Marchand is related to.
David?
Has anyone determined, like, square footage, the difference between the old and the new? Like, what that square footage of the overall?
We have a net increase, and I can't tell you.
Land area.
A net increase of land area, same building size.
Okay. Building, and the land area, and under the 40B regulations on a change of a project, and this is through the regulations that we looked, that if somebody was doing a 40B project and for some reason wanted to add land to it, there are no legal issues of doing it. If they wanted to take land away, then there is a major issue. But by adding it, there's no issues at all.
So since the 40B got approved, there's been additional land added to the property?
Correct.
And about, what, an acre? Is that my understanding?
Approximately. Almost, more than three quarters.
Almost, three quarters of an acre. Has there been any substantial changes to landscaping or lighting or anything that from what was approved here?
What our proposal is that we would comply with the, since the 2013 plan, the one that we're asking you to give us the nod on, was approved, site plan approval by the planning board. Our proposal is to build that project like the special permit project that this board approved and the planning board approved. So to that extent, I can't sit here, Mr. Eagle, and tell you that every traffic light is in the same spot, but...
You mean house light?
House lights, or not traffic lights, street lights, okay. I mean, things had to change somewhat because we're changing the site.
Well, there are no streetlights, anyway.
There are no streetlights.
On either plan?
No.
They were taken away in the beginning plan when we did the first one. We requested, it was an issue with the neighbors that asked for...
But the amount of paved area is pretty much the same, the width of the drives from the street, the sidewalk.
I mean, if you look at the overlay plan, I would call it substantially the same.
Because I know that...
It's a little different configuration, but...
I know that there was an issue when it was the 40B where with potential school buses, you know, there was a school, you know, maybe a bus stop or something that we would have to consider. That's obviously been eliminated.
Right.
With this, okay. All right, I don't have any other questions.
I don't have any questions.
Okay, you have nothing at all? Okay, the... What, Andrew?
I have one other follow-up question, which is just understanding this procedurally. If there was a comprehensive, a 40B permit granted, and then there was a special permit granted for the senior housing, then why is there a need to then go back and modify the comprehensive permit where it looks like what you're really building is something that related to the special permit?
Because we are unable to build the special permit project because it's been tied up in litigation and may or can be for the foreseeable future. And after delaying this now for the better part of 5 years, my client decided that he wants to go forward and request the right to construct it under the special permit plan. And we feel that it's a better layout. We feel that this board thought it was a better layout when you granted the special permit back in 2013. We feel that we've addressed a lot of the issues that were raised in the 40B concern by the neighbors, and that's why we're going forward with it.
Okay, I understand. Thank you.
Did the number of bedrooms change?
No.
No, all that is all, I mean, if you go through the other report, and I read the original on the 55, of the 55 and over, that says basically everything's the same. It's very little. They only made one other change that was done. The drawing, they took away the little recreational field that was there. They just eliminated it, which 55 and over, they don't need it, so it's not a major issue to remove it. And it doesn't have to be done in the documents or anything to be done that way, Monjon said. So the thing we need to do is we need a motion made, either approval or disapproval of it, and what we do. Excuse me. Yes?
May I address the board?
No. I am not allowed to have a public discussion with the public. Mr. Monjon explained to me very clearly, I read your letter, excuse me, I read the letter that you wrote, which technically was sent at the right, it wasn't, but we did do it. I made sure all the board members, they were emailed today to make sure they read it all, and everybody's looked at it, and I think everybody's taken it in consideration of what's said in it and what it is, so we've done all that. Get a microphone behind you, please.
Has Mr. Marchand put anything in writing that you've reported to the board today?
No.
So it's just you reporting to the board what Mr. Marchand said.
That's right. And Mr. Marchand gave me the authority to say what I said, and he also gave me the authority to state that he feels there is no substantial change to this project. He was going to be here tonight, but he had another project to go to. He made it very clear, under the rules and regulations of the state of Massachusetts on a 40B project, this issue is not a public meeting. It's just a public meeting. It's a discussion of the board. We had to write, which Mr. Monchant made me do, and asked Mr. Carrizzato and Mr. DePietri to be here tonight so we could ask them questions only. No presentation made or anything. We used the letters that we were given and everything. And that is the law and the way to do it under the 40B project.
So, Mr. Chairman, you're saying that the law is that...
Excuse me, you need to use the mic, sir.
You're saying, Mr. Chairman, that the law is you can listen to one side, you have an open meeting, and you're going to preclude the other side from making a brief comment so they can elucidate the law and help you try to make a fair decision. Is that your position, Mr. Bartolini?
No. Did you agree in the letter that you wrote was your comment, sir?
What?
The letter you wrote me, was that your comments?
Those are my comments those were my comments in writing, Mr. Bartolini, which I thought when you refused to initially circulate them because it didn't meet the 10-day rule, and it's kind of impossible to meet a 10-day rule when you have 7 days' notice. I think it would be beneficial to the board to hear the viewpoint of the regs, because, and I'm not going to get into it if you tell me not to, but the regs to me clearly would declare this a substantial change, and there's nothing wrong with having a hearing on whether or not the substantial change and have this project go through it. If I would like to have an opportunity to give the board 3 or 4 sentences why it's expressly substantial, but if you preclude me from that, I don't think it's a matter of law. You have the right to preclude me. But
we're not precluding you, Mr. Cavanaugh. We read your letter that you wrote us, and technically in the 10-day issue and everything, but we took it in consideration, and we did not have to post this meeting. We could have put it under other business, but I didn't do it. I put it on agenda. Okay. I did do it that way.
That's good to know, Mr. Bartolini.
And we have to have 20 days to do it in. Today is the 16th day that we have to approve it. And you wrote that in your letter, so I know you understand all that.
I don't understand that you don't have that you would put it in as other business.
I didn't. I put it in. I could have. I did not have to put it, but I put it under the main agenda, so everybody knew what it was and stated what was being done.
Mr. Bartolini, I would request that you ask the board if the board will let me address the change of form of tenure, because I don't think that's been adequately answered, and it's been a one-sided conversation here.
Well, I mean, we don't. It's the board's quest. We can, if you want to let the attorney do it.
Here's my thought on Lee, really quick. I mean, I'm not sure what exactly the law is and what the public hearing aspects of this are, but just one global thought without getting into the substance. If we end up approving this and the abutters challenge it, it may be a basis. If we're wrong, then we're going to give them a basis to challenge it, the fact that we didn't give them a public hearing.
Well, number one, they can't challenge it. They would have to sue everybody.
Well, that's what I mean.
There's no appeal period or anything.
So it's just one consideration. Is
the, so, well, it's the board's. Does the board want to let Mr. Kablak make a statement? It's up to the board.
Now, I personally would like to hear the opponent's position on it.
No, I mean, you've got the letter he wrote, so, but whatever.
I have the same thought as Tom, is that, you know, we're here, and the letter was pretty... stated the position pretty clearly, but if the abutter's attorney wants to elucidate it on it, and then, you know, I will listen.
Okay. Mr. Eagle?
I don't really find it of interest to listen to what I've read it, unless the attorney has things beyond what he submitted to us, because it took me 2 hours to go through it line by line. If he has anything beyond what he submitted to us, then I'd definitely be interested in hearing some additional input. If the board agrees, I don't have an objection to giving him a limited time, maybe 5 minutes, to sort of do a specific challenge to some things maybe that was said tonight. I have no problem with that.
And Paul?
I don't have a problem either, but I think what was said has already been said, but
all right, then I'm agreeable to do so. Mr. Baccarat, we'll let you make a similar of some of a presentation, and that's it.
Well, I'm going to be real quick, because okay. the regulation specifically.
There's one thing I want to clarify before you go forward that was in your letter that was a misstatement, and now Mr. Cavalier to correct me, because I've reviewed it and reviewed the court case. This plan, your court case that you have, which has nothing to do with this board at all, we have nothing to do with the law court case that's present over the 55 and over, but in your letter, you stated that this drawing is in that. The court case is under a special permit, not the drawing.
I think that's a distinction without any meaning. This over 55 project for which you issued a special permit is under appeal before the Massachusetts Appeals Court. Whether you want to say this drawing that they're putting into the 40B, this drawing is not part of the special permit and isn't before the court. So I just don't understand your point, Mr. Bartolini.
No, I'm just saying that it's not a special permit. Mr. Carranzaro, could you clarify my...
Well, the special permit is before the appeals court. The land court had upheld this board's decision on the special permit, granting the special permit, and now it's under appeal to the appeals court. Part of the special permit was the approval of the plan, which was also approved by the planning board. So they're one and the same plans, and if I was pressed on, is this plan part of that appeal? It's part of the special permit that's under appeal.
Okay.
So then in that sense, it is part of the appeal, but the issues on appeal have nothing to do with the plan. The special permit appeal was based on two essential issues, one being whether or not the bylaw was lawful, and the other one, whether or not the plaintiffs had standing. So the plan isn't being challenged. It's the underlying bylaw that was being challenged, and whether or not there was standing.
No, I have no concern on what the challenges were, but the plan was my issue. Okay, Mr. Kablak.
I just want to focus on this claim here that there's no precedent. We're focusing on putting aside the differences in the plan, which we think are substantial, but the board's heard enough on that. But the regs clearly say it's substantial if there's a, quote, change from one form of housing tenure to another. The clear and plain definition of tenure is how something is held, holding an office, holding a position, how the houses are held. Right now, the change here is they're changing it from unrestricted age ownership to changing it to an over 55 restriction, which means that why this is substantial and why change of tenure is a substantial point, and I think this is important for the board to listen to, each of you, is because if it's, you're now restricting who can buy into this, families with kids are now not going to be able to get the low-income housing that was approved initially, and it's being restricted to over 55. And that's why I think if you do some research, you'll find that that's considered under the regulations, why that's a substantial change and why a hearing should be held on that substantial change. And we also put in, as an attachment, again, it's not controlling, but persuasive, that the town of Weston, that in its regulations is defining substantial change, indicates that a substantial change is, if you have an under 55 and you change it to an over 55, that's a substantial change. So I want to highlight those points because I think the board is making a mistake and rushing to a judgment and allowing something it shouldn't if it approves this without having the hearings that are required for a substantial change. If you have any questions, but I think it's real important the fact that you're now limiting the number of who could buy this, whereas you approved it so families with kids could buy it. Now you're completely cutting out a class of people.
Well, there's a major issue with that. Go back. One thing right now in the lots, it's been 18 months plus, it's about 2.5 years. We've got over 62 affordable units in the town of Southborough. We have another 24 or 25 under the process of being approved. We've already approved 22, anyway, so we've taken it. The other thing that's a major issue in the town of Southborough is the seniors are looking for a place to live. They are trying very hard to have housing that they can live. There's issues going on with Shop C on all this and different things, and this is a major issue to help them.
And
a 55 and over project is considered a lot better for a neighborhood versus under a 55 year over project where there's all kinds of kids and people in and out all the time and everything, and it's stated that way.
Mr. Chairman, that's,
yes?
I'm not going to get into a long debate with you. I appreciate the elderly and the over 55. I'm over 55 and I'm would love housing, and I appreciate the fact that this is a major issue, but that doesn't deter from the fact that on this plan, that's a substantial change that must go through a hearing process if you want to make that change. And if you want to make that change after the hearing, that's a different issue. But to make the change and to do that and declare that the change in age restriction is insubstantial, to me, is a violation of the regulations.
Well, I'm in favor of what Mr. Monchon has told us, and he's felt that it's completely opposite of what you said. And as a state representative, a special counsel for the town of Southborough, and his statement was very clear that the 55 and over was not a substantial change, and there was no reason to do a public hearing within 30 days. So that was made very clear.
Does Mr. Marchand provide this information to the whole board or just yourself?
Just myself. I'm not here. I am not here lying to my board or the public on what Mr. Marchand said.
I think, Mr. Chairman, that it should be in the record in writing, or he should be present for the board to hear.
It doesn't have to be. Okay? All right. All right. We're set. Okay. I'd like to see a motion.
Should we have discussion about it?
Well, we discussion.
No, we're still discussion.
We're not a public hearing,
no,
so we don't need to close
a
public hearing.
We want. But, you know, I mean, I've told him Mr. Marchand did say all he did. He would have been here if he could tonight, but he had another meeting to go to. And I didn't request him to, what do you call it? He did this on his own for us, which, I mean, was very good for the town of Southborough. And he said there's been many of them done before. Some have gone some way and some have gone the other. But he says in lieu, it's, you know, for the size of the project and everything, if it was a major project of a couple hundred units, then it'd be a different story altogether. But such a small project at this size and everything, it doesn't, you know, if it was like it's here, I think he had said if it was over 50, 60 units or something, then it would become, but where it's only 15 or 16 units, right? 15?
15.
15 units. It's not a major change at all. Or
can I say one other quick thing, and I just neglected.
I'm going to let this go because, I mean, technically, I was told that we asked questions, and I mean, I don't mean to do that, but that's what I was, you know. If there's any questions for the board, ask them, but do we have any questions among discussion on ourselves on this? I mean, I think that what Mr. Marchant was 100% right. As far as the engineering drawings went, I reviewed them 100%. I mean, I found a few major things. One thing that was different, which has nothing to do with the ZBA board, was the septic system design. Due to the 55 and over, the septic system design was made a little smaller, but that has nothing to do with us at all. That was approved by the Board of Health, which we have no say in any of that. But I've spent a lot of time reviewing the plans because Mr. Marchant made me, and to know the technical engineering issues, and they're on it. And the major thing in the benefit of the town is the 55 and over, because a lot of our residents that are over 55, which I'm one, but I can't do it because I'm going to vote for this, but are looking for units, and they can't find them in the town of Southborough. And this would be a major benefit for the town of Southborough to approve this.
I mean, it seems to me that the two issues are whether, you know, the change in the layout, moving the units around is substantial or insubstantial. And on that, I mean, I guess, on a visceral level, it seems significant. But, I mean, I don't know, when I look at the criteria in the regs and the way they've stated them, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't seem to violate any of the examples of substantial, that, of changes that would constitute substantial. So I guess I'm convinced that the change of the layout isn't substantial. I mean, I'm still a little bit scratching my head a little bit about this change in tenure as to whether the change of, you know, 9 over 55 to age restricted over 5 is substantial or not. I mean, I'm candidly scratching my head about that, but I agree that on a operational basis that, you know, the over 55 would tend to have less impact than a non-age restricted unit. So I guess if there's going to be a tiebreaker, I would tend to break it in favor of finding that over 55 is not substantial.
Okay. Any other? And one of the other things to clarify is the fact that the planning board approved this, and they approved the location of those units and everything. So
right, but that's not the issue, though. That's a different issue.
And we saw that also when we did the approval on this.
We approved both plans. The only
that's
question
right.
is whether
so it's not something that this is coming in to us that we never saw or anything before. It's something that we did do when we did the special permit prior to the planning board. So it's not something that's just come out of the woodwork on us to do.
But to be clear on that point, we approved both plans. So the only real issue is whether going with the new plan over what the plan we approved is substantial or not. I think my own personal view is it's not substantial. But I think that's the only decision we're supposed to make tonight is whether it's substantial or substantial. Right.
Any further discussion? Okay, can I have a motion made then?
I move that we vote to find that the new plan presented by the applicant does not constitute a substantial change of the original 40B project plan.
And the 55 and over.
Oh, you mean, as presented, the changes they presented right. in their application, right. which includes the 55 and over.
And the 55 and over. Okay, do we have a second?
I'll second that.
Okay, is there any further discussion on it? Okay, all in favor? Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
There is no scheduling as far as, you know, thing tomorrow. It will get just filed with the town clerk as a normal piece of paper. That's it. And if you want a copy of the, it's all it's going to be is
we'll just check with the town clerk or with
yeah,
Karen.
All it's going to be is just what the vote was. There's no conditions or anything going along with it. The thing is, we have the plans to put on file that replaces it, and
December 18th, 2013.
Pardon me?
Plan.
No, we have a new one. A big one.
That is the date.
Yeah.
And it says 40B plan.
No, I'm fine.
All right, so we're all set. You can buy it and grab that.
Oh, I haven't had surgery.
Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that.
So, you know, that was like 2-3 months ago you saw me with the brace on. So I finally had an MRI 2 weeks ago, and they said, yeah, you tore your ligament.
Right off the. Oh.
So they had to go in and fish it out.
And you were in pain?
You know, I was, but like the excruciating pain for like 4 days after it happened, then it was okay, and then, you know.
Are you left or right?
Excuse me, one minute. Can we make a motion to adjourn?
I'd like to make a motion to adjourn.
With a second?
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Can you shut our mics off?
Yep.